Let's now go into the Bears' defense against the Jaguars' offense. And this is where I have a little bit of pause, Tim.
Okay.
Let me ask you this question. Let me ask you a couple of questions just off the top of your head. Who averages more yards a game on offense, the Bears or the Jaguars?
I don't know.
Take a guess. What do you think?
The Jaguars, because you told me.
It is the Jaguars. Yes. Yes, Tim. It is the Jaguars. How about this? A way to ruin it for me. How about this one?
Tell me.
Which team averages more passing yards per game, the Jaguars or the Bears?
I'm going to say the Bears.
Wrong. It's the Jaguars.
How about rush yards per game? Oh, go ahead.
Rush yards per game. The Bears average one more rush yard a game than the Jaguars.
Bam.
So what we're looking at here is, honestly, the Jaguars' offense isn't so bad. And it's actually a little bit better than the Bears' offense. So the question here now is whether or not the Bears' defense can sort of hold down the Jaguars offense. I mean, it's not a top 10 offense by any stretch of the imagination, but it's in the middle of the pack. And they are better than the Bears at this. So if there's one place where I'm kind of like, this might be a little bit of a challenge, it's on the defensive end for the Bears. You know, but all of those things, of course, also point to the fact that James Robinson is questionable.
Yes, that's huge.
And he hasn't practiced all week, and he's been their stud running back all season.
He's been amazing, John. Talk about a player coming out of nowhere. He's from Illinois State, so awesome, because I lived in Normal Bloomington for about 5 years. So I was there. I saw him play once. He was really great. He has over 1,070 yards on the season. He has a ton of touchdowns, 4.5 yards per attempt. He's their bell cow, dude. He has 49 receptions for 344 yards. And he had a huge wheel route for touchdown. So this guy, it affects the game at every level. He's almost like how Jordan Howard was for us a few seasons ago.
Mm-hmm.
When that's pretty much all the offense they have. He's hard to stop. Like I said, 10 TDs on the year. And especially the Bears are giving up, what was it? Bears are giving up 118 on the ground.
Mm-hmm.
But they did give up last game against Dalvin Cook, 158.
Yeah.
So they're getting a little shredded. I'm a little worried about that, but the key for the Bears, and we'll get into that, is getting an early lead. So we want to neutralize the run game if Robinson's in the game,
mm-hmm.
which is so important. But son, I want to ask you, do you know who's starting for the Jaguars tomorrow?
Unfortunately, it's not Uncle Rico.
No!
I would have loved to see. It's the other guy, the former Bear, Mike Glennon.
It's Monster Neck guy. He's Draft Neck.
Look. And this might be the revenge game, right? So there might be something to play for here if you're Mike Glennon, right?
You got $15 million from the Bears. I mean, is it such a revenge?
Yeah, I suppose.
Right? He's been pretty good, all right? So he played in three games. Two of his three games, they only lost by 5 points total. He went into Minnesota. He almost beat them. He went for 280 passing yards against the Vikings. Now, the Vikings have a horrid defense, as seen versus New Orleans and us.
Yes.
And then he also went for 235 against Cleveland in a game they almost won. They lost by 1 point.
Hmm.
So there is some danger with Glennon, especially with Vildor and Shelley getting getting a lot of reps.
Mm-hmm.
The key in this game is the fact that the Jaguars gave up 5 sacks last game to the Ravens. The Bears, when they destroyed the Texans, had 7 sacks.
Mm-hmm.
So it's time for us to heat up.
Yes.
And I think that's where I'm going to see in my prediction. I'm going to go into this, but I want Mac and I want Quinn to get going. I still want Nichols to continue his tear. How we do on pass rush, especially with blitzes coming in, please, Pagano, use stunts and blitzes, is going to really tell the tale of the game.
Yeah. I agree, Tim. It's, again, I think all signs point to a Bears win, But yeah, I mean, I think if there's one place where the Bears might have trouble, it's in the run game, their defense.
It's kind of frustrating in a weird way. It's interesting because everybody's talking. I saw a couple of people who thought the Bears were going to lose this week. And it was centered around the fact that these players, and this is a whole nother discussion, but these players don't care about tanking, just like the Jets. They're playing for their lives because probably half the team isn't there next game. If that was the case, though, Gardner Minshew has 16 touchdowns and 5 interceptions on the year. You would think he'd be playing for his life, possibly for his next team. So they benched him, which kind of tells me maybe the coach is tanking a little bit. I'm not 100% sure.
Yeah, I mean, like you know, and obviously the players are not tanking. I mean, some of them are playing for contracts. They're playing for their next contracts. They're playing for their next team. They're definitely not tanking. But, you know, losing has a way of just sort of begetting more losing. And they just, you know, when you're losing, for some reason, you tend to be more unlucky when it comes to a lot of the 50-50 plays. And unfortunately for Jacksonville, it's just gone the wrong way. And if, I mean, I think it's very possible. I could see this as the Bears winning a very close game, like a 20-17 game. I could definitely see that.
Don't get me that, man.
Yeah. I mean, it's
I don't want that.
It's possible because, like, you know, we talked about it before. Once the players get on the field, there is no tanking. They want to win. Both sides want, there's, you know, it's competitive once it gets on the field. So, we can't just assume that the Bears are going to win the game just because both teams are going in opposite directions. And, you know, the Bears are definitely trending up and playing the best football we've seen, but it doesn't matter. They still have that on the field.